Home Assistant 2024.2 update is here, or it will be pretty soon, and I'm diving into 10 awesome new features, from drag-and-drop automation editor through some Tuya integration updates and icon revolution. But let's explore them all, starting with the first of 10 new feature, which is streamlined automation editing. The days of toggling settings to enable reordering in the automation editor are gone. Now, with just a simple drag and drop, you can seamlessly arrange triggers, conditions and actions effortlessly. Plus, the new capability to drag elements into nested conditions opens up a world of possibilities, as some actions support conditions, so you can drag and drop from conditions to the action section without any restrictions. Next, ever wanted to dive deeper into your automation statistics? Now, in Home Assistant 2024.2 and onwards, you can download the data from the history dashboard as a CSV file. This is allowing you to do further analysis in tools like Excel or visualize it in different ways. Thanks to this improvement, you have even more control over your home automation insights. There are some exciting news for the tech nerds in this 2024.2 release as well, because Home Assistant now runs on the latest Python 3.12 version. This bringing not only increased speed, but also laying a solid foundation for future enhancements. If you're using Home Assistant operating system or container or supervised installation type, the upgrade of Python 3.12 is seamlessly handled during your routine Home Assistant upgrade, and you don't have to do nothing else. Just enjoy the ride. But if you're using Home Assistant Core, you'll get a repair notification saying Python 3.11 is still working, but we are moving to 3.12, so please upgrade in timely manner. If these Home Assistant installation types confuse you, or you just want to learn more, like their pros and cons, feel free to join my webinar at automatelike.pro/webinar, and this webinar is absolutely free. Zigbee Home Automation integration now introduces update entities to Home Assistant, so you can receive notifications about firmware updates for your Zigbee devices, and not only that, you can trigger updates directly from Home Assistant. This will work for most of the known Zigbee devices apart from the ones coming from IKEA, at least for now. But who knows, they may include them as well in the next release. Just have in mind that updating process of the devices takes very long time, so be patient and don't rush it. Small but good step towards a smarter, more connected home, don't you think? Home Assistant's commitment to Matter devices shine through with added diagnostic information and controls in the user interface. You can also take actions such as pinging Matter devices, starting commissioning or removal of fabrics, and forcing full device re-interviews for complete Matter standard experience. All of these features makes Home Assistant fully compliant Matter controller. A new addition to the Assist configuration dashboard lets you track all known Assist devices in your home. It is a handy feature providing insights into the active Assist devices, making your home management more transparent. In the latest Home Assistant 2024.2 release, exciting changes have been made to how icons are handled. Now, icons play a more significant role, allowing integrations to offer specific icons for various functions. This update in icon handling is a step toward future development, although it doesn't bring noticeable changes to the user interface just yet. Home Assistant integrations can also use these new icon possibilities and can provide different icons for different fan speeds or thermostat presets, for example. Moreover, every service in the automation or script editor is now having an icon, enhancing the overall visual experience. Additionally, users can now add icons to areas for personalized touch in the area section. These user-friendly updates pave the way for a more visually appealing and functional Home Assistant experience in the near future. Stay informed about integration authentication issues effortlessly. Home Assistant now displays these issues on the repairs dashboard, providing a centralized location for monitoring and addressing system concerns. As always, there are some other noteworthy changes in this update. Here are some of them. Errors got an update. No more confusing coding jargon. Sweet. Switching things up. Now, when you change switch types to a garage door, flipping behavior is a breeze. EcoVac integration got some love. If you are such user, you will appreciate it. There is an automatic cleanup of old refresh tokens. Stay logged in, but only if you have been around in the last 90 days. A nice and security-oriented feature. There is one great TUI update. It is a big one, and I actually like it a lot, as no more developer accounts and complicated setups are needed. TUI developed a special new authentication mechanism just for Home Assistant, and now adding TUI devices is a breeze. You just need the TUI Smart or Smart Life app, and in just few guided steps, you'll be good to go. No more fuss. Please tell me in the comments, are you going to try this new TUI integration? And there is one Jinja template filter that can be useful if you are a template ninja. There are new integrations that can now be set up right from the UI, and these are GPS information collected by GPSD. The proximity integration allows you to monitor the proximity of devices or persons to a particular zone and the direction of travel. The time and date integration, which allows you to create sensors for the current date or time in different formats. We also have quite a number of new regular integrations as well in this latest Home Assistant 2024.2 release. And because there are really a lot, I'll just list them quickly and we'll leave the fun to you to further explore them and dive deep if some of them catch your eye. Don't forget to check the backward incompatible changes, formerly known as breaking changes, as they may affect your system negatively. Also, one new virtual integration is added as well, and virtual integrations are steps that are handled by other integrations. So in this case, support for devices by City of Austin utilities in Home Assistant is now provided by the All Power integration. Home Assistant continues to evolve, making smart home management accessible to everyone. If some of the terms that I'm using are not so clear for you, download my smart home glossary at automatelike.pro/glossary. It is all free. Thanks for watching. I'm Kirill, and until next one. Bye!